Couple nacelles. Fuel bladders. Rubber fuel bladders. You know, there's a ton of fuel cells. Look how small some of the cells are. No wonder there's like over 20 cells inside the Turbo Commander. They're tiny. Looks like somebody just took a chainsaw. You know, this kind of adds to the ambiance here. Fortunately, no one was hanging from it on a meat hook. So where your radar would be connected. Right here. Shelf for all kinds of avionics packages. Man, they just took a freaking saw and just cut this puppy right in half. Look at that. Just cut right through the wiring bundles. Please make sure your seatbelts are fastened. Engine mounts for the Garretts. These are the connection points.
Man, look at all those guts. Break.
Wing. Tail. Wing root. Must be the connection points.
This is the unpressurized tail fuselage tail cone, or behind the cargo compartment, and this is where all the electronics gyros, lots of large old school converters, the inverters. Batteries are stored back here. What's missing is the environmental system, which would be like right here.
Now, hopefully this was all done after the plane was taken apart, and that's not a official repair when the plane was in service. I don't think duct tape is part 23 certified. Really? You had to cut the Rockwell logo? Aileron. Oh my God, anybody know what that is? Well, if you spent any time in the military, I can tell you that is the end of a Army issued cot, which always was a mother to put together. Y'all have been in the Army know exactly what I'm talking about. Air scoop for the environmental system. I'll bring the outside air in, get mixed into plenum for either heating or cooling. Water separator. The jets.